Functions behave nicely at points where a function is analytic. We will now encounter singular points. You might expect this is the name for points where a function is not analytic. While that is almost correct, but not entirely, as you will see in this video. Because z0 is a singular point of f of z, or if f of z is not analytic in z0, but also analytic in a point in every neighborhood of z0. The second part is a bit cryptic, but let's look at a few examples. So we have, for example, our f of z equals 1 over z and z0 equals 0. Well, f is not even defined there, so certainly not analytic. So is f a singular point or not? Well, then we also have to satisfy the second condition. We need to find another point in every neighborhood such that the function f of z is analytic in this other point. So we take a neighborhood of the 0, the yellow circle. So we can take any yellow open circle. And then within this yellow circle, we will have to find another point and a green circle over here, such that f of z is analytic within this green circle. Well, that's possible, of course, because this function 1 over z is differentiable everywhere else. So we can just take any point and make a small circle around it, as long as you make a circle small enough such that you don't meet the origin. So you can find for every yellow circle another point in the yellow circle, make your green circle, and f is analytic in this whole green circle. What happens if you take this function 1 over sine of pi over z? That looks a bit awkward. Well, a sine is of course analytic, pi over z is analytic. The only problem is, of course, if you're dividing somehow by 0. Well, first of all, for z equals 0. And you have, of course, a problem if sine of pi over z equals 0. And that happens if the argument of the sine equals a multiple of pi. So pi over z equals a multiple of pi. So if z equals 1 over k, where k is some number in z, or at z0 equals 0. So the points where the function is not defined are the red dots, and they are all on the real axis. Now let's again look at 0. Is 0 a singular point? Well, first of all, it's not even defined there, so certainly not analytic. Now we draw a yellow circle around it, and we have to be able to find our green circle. Again, we can take a point over here, make the green circle, and indeed, inside the green circle, our f of z is analytic. Notice the formulation. So first you draw a neighborhood, then you have to find another point in the neighborhood such that f of z is analytic. You do not need to find a neighborhood of 0, such that in this neighborhood of 0, in the deleted neighborhood, f is analytic, because that's also not the case in this case. No, it's slightly different, it's slightly weaker. Only thing you have to find is a point somewhere else close enough such that your function is analytic. So it's quite a subtle difference. For practical purposes though, you will usually be fine. Then, last example, f of z equals the modulus of z squared. Well, this function has no singular points at all, because it's nowhere analytic, so we will never be able to satisfy the second condition. So singular points are the points which you expect, where you expect them to be, but the definition, especially the second point, is slightly tricky if you want to apply it correctly.